Hello and welcome to this short explanation of A-level Sociology Year 1 examination. This is for Socialisation, Culture and Identity, which is Section A of the first exam paper. The first point to make is we're having mock examinations. The reason for these is not to catch people out as much as to find out what we don't know. With uncertainty, we've got confusion. We need to know what we do not understand. The most useful feedback is to the teacher about what the students don't understand, and so that they can help the student. If you have that uncertainty, you don't know the route to success. How can the teacher help you unless you know the route to success? So you need some meaningful failure. You need to put the effort in so you get some good constructive feedback from the teacher. How can they provide such feedback unless you put the effort in? A decent job of revision. The classes that have been taught topics, we're only going to set mock exams on the topics taught so far. Okay, so the sociology exam, Section A, is Socialisation, Culture and Identity. Section B is the family topic. So where students have been taught Section A only, they're only going to be assessed on Section A. So we assessed on Section A twice. Where students have learned some of the family topic, they'll be set on questions on Section A and Section B. So Section A, you've got a 4 mark, a 6 mark, 8 mark, 12 mark. The 4 mark question, if we spend 5 minutes on that one after we've read through the source material, then we're going to do the first question in 5 minutes. We'll spend 10 minutes on the next question. 10 minutes on the next question after that. And the last question, that will give us 20 minutes. And that's a total of 45 minutes, half the exam time. We've got 90 minutes, an hour and a half overall. The first question, you're basically giving a core definition. So if it was to define the concept of values, you'd be talking about, you know, values are defined as, you know, beliefs about what is considered important, worthwhile and desirable. For example, Muslims believe in the concept of modesty and obedience. This is demonstrated by clothing such as the headscarf, which is an example of covering the body so that one is modest rather than immodest. That would go towards 4 marks. Basically looking for 2 or 3 sentences with evidence. That was conceptual evidence. I could have mentioned the functionalist view that culture is needed to provide social order, perspectives evidence. I could refer to studies evidence. Parsons argues that power serves collective goals, values are needed to keep everyone in their place, to promote social order, so studies and key names like Parsons. I could mention data. There's a concern over a loss of values. For example, 50% of ethnic minorities live in an area where whites are the minority. I suggest there's a loss of integration into common values. Yeah, that would also be a bit of data from a study. So you need evidence in your answer, 2 or 3 sentences, 5 minutes, a small paragraph. Probably half a page maximum, you could write. Second question, with reference to the source, so you need to refer to the source material which you're given to help you. Identify and briefly explain 2 examples of values. So in my first answer, I kind of gave an example of values there. So it was really the core definition they're looking for, more than examples in the first question. Second question, you're going to briefly explain 2 examples of values. So it could be the importance placed on the sanctity of human life, the importance placed on education. And then again, you'd be giving evidence for that in terms of studies, data, contemporary examples, and sociological perspectives like Marxism and feminism. So again, that's probably going to be in 10 minutes. You're probably going to write a maximum of a side of A4, maybe 2/3 of a side of A4. 2 clear paragraphs, clearly identify the examples and give evidence to support each one. Question three, 8 marks. Using the source and your wider sociological knowledge, explain how norms are relative. Okay, so this is going to be some overall principle, like the cultural relativity of social norms, or the idea of hybridity, cultural hybridity. It could be anything to do with socialization or culture or identity. So with this one, again, you're giving evidence. If we give 10 minutes to this, again, we're looking at 3 or 4 paragraphs in 10 minutes, and in each bit is going to explain that. So it might be norms are relative in terms of time, space, context. So in terms of history over time, relativity of norms, how they've changed over time in history, like attitudes to homosexuality. In terms of place, comparing cultures and how they vary in different geographical places, like Saudi Arabia compared to the contemporary UK. And context, you know, like nudity, depending on the setting, in your private bedroom or in a public place, how we view behaviour. So you could give examples, studies, data, contemporary examples and perspectives to support the discussion. You could refer to, you know, postmodernism, functionalism and so on, feminism. 10 minutes, 3 or 4 paragraphs, give evidence. Key names and so on. Number four, outline and briefly evaluate the view that individuals learn society's norms through the process of primary socialisation. So basically most of this one, in 20 minutes, most of it is going to be explaining how primary socialisation is important in shaping norms. That's most of the answer. And you're going to give evidence in you know, 15 minutes. You can give 3 or 4 paragraphs where you explain evidence to show that norms are learned through primary socialisation. For example, you have a functionalist view about norms learned in the family. So with this one, give 15 minutes to the outline. 3 or 4 points, different studies, key names, perspectives. So we could give, you know, a paragraph on functionalism. We could talk about the idea of the nuclear family, the idea of gender roles and learning, you know, the gender roles according to Parsons, instrumental and expressive roles, Murdoch, the universality of the nuclear family, feminism, talk about, you know, gender role socialization, Oakley. So you've got key names and perspectives. 3 or 4 times, you're going to do that. Data, contemporary examples, key names. There's going to be a brief evaluation paragraph, which is literally 5 minutes, where you're considering the problems with the view that primary socialisation gives norms. So the problems with that view. So whatever the view is in the question, you've got to discuss the problems with it in a small paragraph at the end of the essay. This is different to a longer essay because you're giving a brief evaluation. In essays later on, you'll be doing more substantial evaluations. This is a small section of weaknesses with the view. So there is a way of structuring this evaluation paragraph, which is MOIP. Firstly, M. You can say it's difficult to measure the factors that affect the learning of norms. In this case, that's the topic, the learning of norms, and you're going to say the difficulties with that. It's difficult to measure how that process takes place, the learning of norms. But you can say that for anything. You know, it's difficult to measure the process. Oh, there are other factors which also affect the learning of norms, such as, and then just list whatever factors are not in the question. So in this case it says primary socialisation, so you refer to secondary socialisation and how that can also affect the learning of norms. So whatever the question is, you've got to consider the weaknesses in it by considering the other factors, how they can play a role. In this case, in the shaping of norms. I, interactionists, they're, you can always refer to them if we're talking about socialisation, because they say socialisation is not a one-way process where you learn norms as an individual from society. The interactionists say it's a two-way process where we make active choices as individuals about how we practice norms and how we perform. So we're active and not passive in learning norms. Make decisions about how to learn norms and what norms we learn. But whatever the question is, we can refer to interactionists and their view that we're active and not passive in forming an identity. Just change it for the question. Postmodernists, we can always refer to postmodernists and say that it's a continuous process of identity formation. It's not just based on socialisation and culture, it's also based on agency. It's changing because of the influence of the media, which is replacing education in importance. The family is becoming less important because it's more unstable, because of changes to the family. We've got more choices in terms of identity. So that gives you a structure for the brief evaluation. But most of your answer, 15 minutes of this, is going to be laying out what is the concept, how is it defined, who would support the view, three or four paragraphs supporting the view and the question, and then this brief evaluation, which you can basically tailor and change slightly for the question. But this is a good way of dealing with that. Okay, so I hope this has been useful. If you have questions, you can email Daniel_Butcher@hotmail.co.uk.